Hi everyone, it's Gail and I am here with Marguerite Miller, and then we'll do some crafting after we do week 28 of Marguerite Miller Challenge. But first let me say hi and hugs. First of all, hi to Joe. Joe is a hubby that watches with his wife, and so special hi and hugs to you, Joe. Thank you for watching. And hi and hugs to Carolyn, Margaret, and Journaling Junkie. Thanks so much for watching and for your nice comments and everything. Okay, guys. Well, we have got on week 28, something wet. I took this picture of Alfie to send to my granddaughter, Katie. And so my something wet is his nose. So that's that. Any kind of tag. I think I'm going to put this tag in. It kind of goes with the colors of Alfie's pictures. It's one of my Ann Brooke challenge that, you know, I'm not doing anymore because of my hand. But I thought it would be a nice way to keep it, to put it in this book. Okay, a pattern with stripes. I have this this paper that I'm going to use to back the pages. Something silver. I have this little charm that I'm going to put on somewhere. Barcodes. I just have some packaging here with barcodes that we can use. And an image from a magazine. I found this, Wildlife Babies, and I thought it would go good with my Alfie. So that's the plan, guys. That's the plan. Let's get started. I'm just gonna get these pages covered. So yeah, Alfie has gone home to his home. I'm gonna just do a little past here, like right about there. Yeah, he has gone home. We ended up taking him home all the way, which it's about an hour and a half. Looking for a glue book. It's about an hour and a half from our house. A little more maybe, depending. And we did have some construction that we ran into and stuff. So, but anyway, so we took him home because my granddaughter Katie ended up in the ER. They were in Phoenix, as you know, as I was telling you, playing volleyball, and she just got sick. She was, you know, nauseous kind of sick. And so she was in the ER getting an IV to get her hydrated. Well, I didn't quite cover that up, so we might have to do something with that. Anyway, so they just hydrated her and gave her some anti-nausea medicine. And this was yesterday. And according to my daughter, she's still not doing very well today. So I don't know what's going on with that little bug. But anyway, But we took Alfie home because we knew that that would make her feel better because she loves that dog more than anything, which is understandable. He's very lovable. So, but, you know, my daughter coming back and trying to work and having a kid in the ER. And, oh my gosh, the last thing she needed was to drive to our house to get her dog. So we just took him. So yesterday was a fun day kind of because my son's family was still here because my grandson is going to a camp that is close to our house. And so it's out at a lake. And so maybe we'll just go like that too. So anyway, I got to go with my son to drop him off because Mike and I are picking him up when the camp is over. So we'll pick him up and then we'll meet his mom halfway and do the switcheroo. And so, yeah, so anyway, we had to do. Okay, I'm liking that so far. Just putting that on there. Yeah, so we did that. We did that and then came home, had lunch, and then Mike and I took off to take this boy to his home. So, yeah, Katie got a kick out of that picture. Kind of fun. So anywho, yeah, you just worry so much when they're sick. It's like, what is going on? So okay, so there's my buddy Al. Okay. He is quite a dog, though. He, I'm sure he'll be really good for Katie being not feeling well because, he is so sensitive. I had a migraine one day when he was here, and he would not leave me. He was just like glued to my side. So sweet. So I don't know. I'm gonna just cut these because I can't use them the way they are. I know that. And then this one. I don't know. The deer ate all of my lilies. So, you are not my favorite right now. Just ate off every single bloom. I was like, seriously, you guys. I don't know, maybe I won't use the fox. Maybe I'll save those for another challenge or something. But, okay, so what I was thinking. Okay, I like that. Liking it so far. I was thinking with these, do I have, hang on one second. I have a heart punch somewhere. Butterflies, butterflies. I don't know where my heart punch is. I was thinking about doing the doing these in a heart shape. Maybe I can just wing it. Do you think? Me winging a heart. It's a little scary. Oh. Oh, it's not horrible. This one's kind of a little bit close to the edge, but maybe I can do it. This one's real thick. I was thinking of trying to peel them off, but okay. We're doing all right. Ooh, this one's easier to cut. It's not as Yeah, so I did want to say on my next few videos, I'm gonna be saying this over and over, but I think I don't know that I'm gonna be we're gonna be missing some videos. Let's just say that. Because I'm behind already this week from taking Alfie home. And this weekend, Addie plays volleyball in her hometown in Bozeman. And then, so we're thinking of going. Apparently, it's more like a tournament than a camp, really. But so we're thinking of going and watching her this weekend. Well, then we get back from that. And I have to get ready to go to Denver. And then we're going to Denver the next Wednesday. So I just don't know that I'm going to have videos all the way through me being gone. So just be advised. I'm A-okay. I'm having fun with my family. And I'll be back as soon as I can. Okay, so I need something to kind of anchor this guy because the only other thing we have, so if something wet, we have a tag, we have pattern with stripes, our silver, which I'm thinking I may hang off of here, barcodes, and image from a magazine. So I think we've got out. Let me see if I can find a bulb pin. All the ones I have buttons on them, which maybe isn't a bad thing. Yeah, so anywho, I just wanted you to be informed that, I'm all good, life is good, but let's see, I need that to go the other way in order to. I think I'm gonna leave the buttons off. I can use those. In another something. Anyway, wanted you to be informed that that would be happening. So I'm doing as many as I can, and then we'll be off on our adventures. So okay, so I think I'm ready to put the pictures down. So, there's that. Life has pretty much returned to normal, and very excited to go see my Denver daughters. I'm sorry, I won't be doing a meet and greet this time. It's just going to be too quick of a trip. And I want to soak up all the time I can with my grandkids that are there and my kids too. So you about right there, Alfie. How's that? Sweet boy. He had his face on my lap, and so so I took this close up of him and sent it to my granddaughter. Okay, we need, let's see, let's do this. Let's get the tag put on there. I'm going to use art glitter glue for that and really smoosh it down. Yeah, I tried to send Katie a picture of Alfie every day. Mostly they were pictures of him sleeping because he's getting older and he does that a lot. He just sleeps. So I kind of this over to the edge So a little bit of that paper shows there. I think I'll probably use that to put the hearts on as well. Okay, getting you all smushed in there. Okay, so we need probably some book page of some sort. What do I have here? Let's just maybe give this a little bit of a tear and perfect piece for stamping on. I have a whole pile over there. I'm gonna have to take time one of these days and get those all stamped. Yeah, that's better. Just have something there. I'd kind of like that paper came from this paper pack. Joanne's was having a sale when I went in there. And that's how I end up with all these paper packs, I think. But I had some ideas for this one. Where is that? Huh. I know there was more than one. Well, let's use this one, because since I can't find the other one, we'll just use this. I just want to have like a little strip in there, I think, of this. So I would like the edges to be a bit torn. Okay. And how big do I want? About to the bottom of this one. So yeah, I was really looking forward to getting back to doing videos because had a day of not because we were taking Al back. That's a bit wide, I feel like, because you can't really tell. Yeah, I think I could take this off. I want to be able to see the writing on the book page like that. Like that. Okay, so that's sorted out. We'll get that on there, and then we're pretty well I'll do a little on this too, just get those white edges off of there. Yeah, so anywho, I'm be honest, I'm not totally looking forward to the marathon car ride to get to Denver. But there'll be three of us that can drive, so that'll be helpful. Last time I went with my son, it was just the two of us. So it'll be nice to have his wife be able to do some driving too. Okay. Now, put that here. Because Alfie can, he can qualify for a, I think I might put that right there. He can qualify for a wildlife baby. Oh gosh, when my son was here for the 4th, he brought his dog. And so there definitely was wildlife adventures happening. My son says he has little dog syndrome, which he does. He thinks he has to, dominate Alfie. And Alfie's like, whatever, dude, you're tiny. Well, I know I want that one there. Okay, well, that's, this one's a little different. A little different, isn't it? Lots of texture with the tag and these. Can't decide what I like better. Do I like that? I think I'm just going to center it. So, there we go. That one is done. There we go. All done. 20 minutes. That's about the average, I would say, for the Marguerite Miller. So now, guess what? We have 40 minutes to play. So, yay. Something wet, tag, stripes, something silver. Barcode, image from a magazine. Bada bing, bada boom. We have ourselves a collage. Okay, so I'll set this aside. And what I'm thinking of doing is, well, I wanted to show you a couple things. So I showed you this pack of paper. And I have some ideas I'd like to do for that. And then, oh, these are just coffee dyed. And then I got this paper pad too. DCWV Preserved Papers, it's called. And first of all, I liked it because it was two-sided. And look at the postcards. I could do Rachel's thing. But it's cute. It's nice paper. And it's, you know, it's good and thick and all of that. So, yeah, I liked it. And it was like buy one, get one free. So, I had to buy two. Oh, that's what happens. Okay, and then I got this book. Rachel, when she did her postcard envelopes for her challenge, she had this book that she was using. And I was like, oh my gosh, I love that. That book. So I went online and purchased it. So it's called Wildflowers of Britain Month by Month, Margaret Erskine Wilson. And so I really love it. She was, long time ago, she was with us a long time ago. So anyway, I don't know if I'll play with that, but first thing I wanted to do is I have this coffee dyed paper, and I got these from Val's Heartfelt Paper, and they're the ones that she stenciled the old, it's old dictionary. And what I'd like to do is put that on some paper and make a pocket out of it. I've been kind of into making pages ahead, kind of like making ephemera ahead. Now let's see, like this one. Yeah, see, that'll make a nice big pocket page. But I'm also thinking these would be really good on, you know, on digitals where you don't have the white sides. So I might look, I printed out these. I showed them yesterday in the Etsy share, the chapter one papers, the petite florals, and you know, all these beautiful florals, which would go with a lot of things too. So I'm just debating if I'd like to just maybe do the first one. I'll just do this one. I had these at hand to play with as well. So let's go ahead. Oh, Mike's got my cutter somewhere. He must have it upstairs. He's been doing a little fussy cutting for me, and he fussy cut some. Don't tell him I told you this. He fussy cut some definitions. He cut off half the word. Oh, he's so sweet to help me, but it's just like, oh shoot, I can't use those. Oh well. It is, I do think it takes a little practice to line up your, you know, line up your cutter. So I'll give him a little grace on that front. Okay, well, isn't that just pretty? That is super pretty. I love that. So, see, I think I'm gonna go that way with it, and this is just going to be a random page for whatever journal. Okay, so then see how nice that will be. But it's pretty, it's vintage definitely, and so it's pretty iffy that way. I want some cardstock. Just one second, I'm going to grab. I don't know that this is big enough, but at least it will reinforce the top edge, you know, is what I'm thinking. Okay, so let's just cut this, and then I can put the glue. Yeah, I just wouldn't really trust it, I don't think, with, but I can then glue down that other part. So yeah, anyway, so we're just gonna do a little this is and that. I also have a drawer of random ephemera that I just would like to get it, you know, use it. So I might look at that too. Okay, and then I just wanna get this lined up just right. And somewhere over here under all my pile of stuff, I have my card, don't I? Yep. Yeah, and that will be good. And then I'll do the three sides. Let's see, do I want to clip a thumb notch? I think I will. I just feel like it makes it easier to get into, so why not? And probably I want to distress it too, right? Probably I do. Oh yeah, that looks cool. Distressed. Yeah. My laundry's beeping at me. That's the other thing I had to get done today because I'm like 2 days late on my laundry. I tell ya, just not enough hours in the day. So then, my thought was just to kind of lay that down. Oh, I think that looks cool. I think I might wanna do the edge of the page too. Now I'd kind of like to feel like this page is done and ready to go into a journal. So I think what I'm going to do is just do a little stencil on this side, because then, I mean, I can put a pocket or whatever. Oh, good grief. So many stencils. Just do this one because it's nearly on top. This is Kath Holden Cathedral, 12 by 12. And I could put, that'd be cute. I'd put this circle right in the middle. Okay, there's that, all stenciled. Okay, cool. So there's a page just ready to go into a journal when we're ready. And in here, we can either put a big, why don't we do that? Let's see, somewhere here. This pretty one. Gonna need to cut it down though to about right there. And then like this page is, I think I want to do the other side. This page is ready to go. Boom, just right into a journal. I think these are three insistent dogs. I think. Let's see if that's gonna. Yeah, it goes nearly all the way in, but there's still a little bit that you can grab, so that's perfect. Okay, that page is done. I have this page that's done, and look at how good that goes together, or how well, I don't know, Montana speak. So I'm going to glue this down. This was just sitting there waiting to be, so let's just finish it. And I had some suggestions on how to glue this, and I understand what you're saying, but I don't know about you, but sometimes when I'm crafting, it's like whatever is at hand, whatever's handiest, whatever I can just quick like do is what I do. To get out other equipment and stuff just to glue something down, it's just kind of not part of my what I do. So thank you though for the suggestions. Always welcome. Yeah, it's not that bad. It only takes a minute. Yeah, I'm excited about that. That's super cute. I had a few people tell me that this is a Cricut die. Well, I don't have a Cricut, but I would love, love, love some more of these if anybody does and wants to sell some. Okay, so now this page is ready to go in a journal too. Fun. All right, so let's see. Where are we? Oh, good. We have lots of time. Okay, so let me show you these that I was talking about. These are just totally kind of random pieces of ephemera and stuff that, like, leftovers and things like that. So I was thinking it would be fun to do something with these. You know what? Those would be about the right size for an accordion booklet, wouldn't they? Let's see if there's a paper in here that would... I mean, there's lots of them that would probably go. That one's nice. It's just really... Let's do this one. Oh gosh, and my husband has my cutter, so I can't cut off the end of that. I can do it back here though, so excuse me while I turn around and do that. 12. Okay, I just needed to get that off. Let's see. So how big do we want these? So I think I'm going to cut it in 6. At 6. Really, these accordion books, you can make them whatever size you want, tall wise. So now we're just going to do a little bit of this. And if I can remember how I did it. Okay, so at 4, between 4 and 8. We do every half inch, but I figured out that doing this, then flipping it, doing it this way and flipping it. Now I'm at 5, 5.5, 6, 6.5. 7, 7.5. I kind of found that they folded better. So let's see how we do. Go as off kilter. Is that right? I have this one that would fold back that way. No, I think I did an extra score mark, but that's okay. No big deal. Okay. So yeah, 4.5. Oh, that's okay. Yeah, so that made it fairly even. Not perfect. It's not perfect. Nothing I do is ever perfect. Okay, so there's one. Let's do this other one too. Okay, I kind of want that to fold over, so I'm gonna go this way. Every half inch. So I think now that one's turning out like I thought it would. Weirdly enough. Okay. I don't know what I did on the other one. Yeah. So, oh, excuse me, I'm sorry. I don't know. But I'm making one bigger than the other. This is what's happening. This one worked like I thought it should. Oh, who knows? Doesn't matter. Really, really doesn't matter. Okay, so I have quite a few of these. I think these are Artie Mays. But this pile of stuff, I'm not absolutely positively positive. I like the more colorful better. Okay. Yeah, I like that. Okay, well, we're going to make two of those real quick. Just in a quick hurry. Let's see, I'm going to need binder clips. Need to put these in my drawer that's closer to me. I think that's a good idea, Gail. All right. First thing I think I'll do is give this a little bit of a well, you know, it may only end up that I end up only having two of these used up out of the ephemera box, but you know, it's progress still and all, it's progress. Okay, so I'm just gonna squish that and clip it. This one, I guess I don't need to really, distress it. I can do that later. You know what I'm thinking for those pictures of girls, those bigger pictures, I'm thinking maybe a bag journal cover. Okay, Okay, so there's those. I'm gonna let those dry for a minute before we put the cover on, but I do think I'm gonna like that. I think that's gonna be pretty cute. Okay, so there's those two. We'll get back to that. But these little ladies, I'm thinking, and my sacks, of course, are clear across the room, I think. I don't think I have any big enough. Let me look up here. See if I have, yes, I do. I have a couple of big ones from A Tattered Dream. Perfect. Might I want one of those doilies, she asks herself. Okay, but I think those would be pretty cute on there. So let's make ourselves a couple little covers here. These have a little bit of adhesive. I think pieces came in this, and so see, because that's torn a little bit, but I can still use them because I can put him just right over that and her just right there. I don't know where those came from, but yeah, but they need a little something in the back of them. Let's see. I have some good coffee dyed doily here that might be nice with her. Okay, I think I need to cut off right there. Just doing some super quick projects, aren't we? I'm thinking I could do that, and then could I put that kind of there? I think that'll work. Just some ephemera use it up ideas, I guess you could call this. Okay. There we go. And then she's going to be right there. And so this could just go like that, I think. I think she needs a little inky. She's got some white happening here. Then we maybe could put like a little flower or something on her. And him, I don't know, I might put some fabric or something behind him. Okay, so I'm gonna have her right about there. Ooh, we're going to be up to using 4 of these ephemera pieces. That's exciting. I think right about there. Cute. And maybe we'll put something else on that. I didn't know. Okay, you little dude. What are we going to put? I don't really want lace behind you, but I don't know that I have any fabric that is close enough here. Let's see. I could put some cheesecloth or something. Or, ooh, what's that? Wait one second. And out of the corner of my eye, I see in my basket some fun lacy stuff that's brown and could go for a little boy. Okay, so we want to cut right about at that flower. Let's just lay this out a little bit. Okay. So this guy has to go back where it was so that I can see it the next time I need something. Okay. All right. So let's put you kind of right there-ish and see what we think. I don't mind that. Extra for something else. Okay, I'm going to glue that down. And we'll just go from there. I feel like you need something a little lighter behind him, maybe, but spatula. Okay. Then, little dude. I think I might put a little book page on the top and book page on the bottom. It's kind of what I'm thinking. Just a little something that would pop him from maybe just at the top even. What about some of this? I don't know. We're gonna try it. Bit right there. I don't mind it sticking out the sides a little bit too. That's okay. I think I'm gonna put that there. And then I think I might put like a book plate at the bottom. It's kind of what I was thinking. I'll show you what I was thinking for a book plate. kind of like that. Okay, and then I have these book plates that I got on Amazon. And I was thinking of one of those down here. They've got itty bitty little screws with them, which I don't really need. I was thinking about maybe putting that like that. Then I would probably fill those holes with stickles. But do I have a word to go in? And am I completely running out of time? I am. But let's see. Do I have... not those ones. A word or a something. I could use one of these numbers, maybe, too. That's too big. Like, something like this one. I could put that in there. I think I will. Okay. If I motor, we will get this done. Just gonna put a little glue around. This and hopefully getting the number centered, which I did. Okay. Now, I think I better Fabri-Tac because we're going on the going on to the lace. Oh, I like that. Really cute. That masculined it up a little bit, I feel like. Okay, then I'll put a couple of drops of gold stickles in those holes. So it almost looks like a screw head. Okay, and that one's done. That one is done. Now, this one, I might put something right there, but I don't know. Okay, let's do these though. Get these done. And really, all that entails is gluing this guy on there. So we'll have four pieces kind of ready to, you know, fill, I guess you could say. So there, and then we just need to put pages in and a little pocket or whatever. And then this one. Once again, just put this on. And then real fast, let's see if we can put a couple things on our little girl cover to. And as we get to decorating these, I don't know that they're necessarily done on the cover. Like maybe we want some, you know, some stickles or some, whatchamacallit, you know. You know, the one kind of glossy accents. Okay, so we got those two done. We got this guy done. Now let's see if we can do something. I think right here She needs something. I'm not quite sure what. I just saw this little piece of lace in my bucket. That's cute. And what do we want to layer on there? We could do some stamps. We could do and a flower or something. Okay, there's that. Sorry guys, just looking to the side here to see what I might have that we might like to put there. That's kind of cute. You know, not my go-to color. Ooh, I think I like that better. I'm going to need a major cleanup before my next fill in my next video. I kind of have everything pulled out. Yeah, I think I'm just going to put that on there, and that's just cute. Okay. Then we did those four little booklet type things, so we just, you know, need to fill them and stuff. We also did a page for a future journal, and we got Marguerite Miller done. It was a decent video's work. There, cute. Okay, so there's her and him, and then we did this little page too. So thanks everybody for crafting with me today, and we will just see you in the next video. Have a grateful day. Bye everybody.